changes on the current agenda. Mandy, would you take a roll call, please?
Bob Richard?
Yes.
Kent Miller?
Yes.
Rick Brown?
Yep.
Tony Gingler?
Yes.
Matt Audi?
Here.
Lloyd Luttrell?
Present.
Robert Peterson?
Yep.
Charlene Abel?
Present.
Thank you. If you'd stand with me for the invocation of the leaders. Dear Heavenly Father, be with us as we go into the Christmas season with the birth of your Son. And let us remember that. And be with us as we move through our meeting this evening and give us the knowledge that we need to make the proper decisions. And be with those that are traveling this Christmas season to visit their families around the state and country. In your name we pray. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Lloyd, do you have anything at this time?
No, thank you.
Matt?
Yeah, I do. Representative Susan Kincannon shared with me today a statistic that I thought was worthy of sharing with everybody else. From SafeWise.com, it said that Beloit was number 16 in the safest cities of all of Kansas. So I thought Chief Phelan deserved a little pat on the back for a job well done, and it was nice to know. And it was also nice because compared to Concordia, they're the ninth most dangerous city in Kansas. So I thought that was pretty bad.
Well, we can definitely, thank our police department for that and Chief Gillum and those people for the job they've done. I was fortunate enough you shared that with me late yesterday afternoon. So there's a lot of things. Another thing that we can have pride about our community. I mean, there's a lot of it.
Keep sending those criminals to Concordia.
Yeah, at least. More rain, they need it. Charlene?
I have nothing.
Yeah. Mr. Brown?
No.
Last time I mentioned Isle of Lights, I want to commend the city crews and those guys for all the help they've given them. I don't think they can pull it off without all that.
So. Yeah, it's definitely a team effort. Yeah. It's nice that we can, our employees are willing to do that, and they will be. They do a good job. Tony?
Oh, a couple of things. They're crushing rock out there by the old Casey store that they're tearing down. That is not Abram doing the crushing or hiring it done. It is the people doing the dirt work. He's had a complaint, rightfully so, because it is close to the house, but it is not him doing it, although it's on his property, but it is the people doing the construction work there at the corner. And somebody was asking me why we only have half the street lights on Main Street from like St. John's to the courthouse.
You got some run-up wires and some trees.
Okay. All right, that's it. Thank you.
Bob? Nothing. Thank you. Katie?
Nothing right now. Thank you.
Go ahead.
I just wanted to, and Matt already talked about a little bit here about the Safe City announcement here today. And that's based on FBI crime statistics. It's based on violent crimes per 1,000, property crimes per 1,000. And we, of course, rank very low in that. So that's why I end up number 16. And all those are actually pretty grouped close together who are considered safe. So, it's another point of pride for us here in our city. So that's all I have.
Okay, thank you. We will now go into our public hearing with Richard Padgett. Richard, you want to come forward and address the council at the podium, please?
Okay. I was given notice to cut down a tree at 414 Mill, Hector Tree. We have the center out of it. But, I was asked to cut it. I was told to cut it down in 30 days. There's no way I could do that. And I'm pretty sure it'll stand until I'm able to get it cut down this spring when it's a little warm. It went through the ice storm, There never was a problem with Noma owning both houses, but now that Carol owns this one, I guess Junior Scott was Mr. Jones, and now it's an issue. It's 45 feet from the city sidewalk, and it's sturdy as can be. It's a hollow there, but if you know, if you're familiar with hackberry whatsoever, it's very hard to split. It's a well grain, and you can't hardly find a hackberry that doesn't have a hole or a split in it. It's just its nature. But anyhow, I believe it'll last until I can get to cutting it down. So I'm just asking for longer time to have it cut it down.
Okay, thank you. Chris, your comment?
Well, the tree's hauled out, as you can see by the pictures we've provided to you, and it's believed that tree could be a risk to the neighbor next door. If an ice storm, snowstorm came upon and collapsed that tree, it would presumably fall on that neighbor's house.
Right.
So it's a risk, it's not worth taking.
Okay. Well, I think we probably need to go ahead and follow up with what Chris recommends, that we get the tree removed.
I remember, but it's not every day.
When did you get the first notice? Been like 60 days now, or
how many?
No, that's fine. Because you wanted to come last night.
November
10th. Yeah. Has it been 60 days?
He was served on November 10th.
November 10th.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just been a month. Now, you don't own both houses.
No, Noma didn't. It was never an issue when she owned them. But just now that Junior's taking over Noma's and E.D. Howard's stuff, it's an issue now. We had one heck of an ice storm. No limbs come off from it then, nor will it all this winter either.
So did this complaint originate with the neighbor, Chris, or was it something you...
No, it's something we've had in mind anyway. The neighbor has talked to me, but as you recall, we've just recently updated our tree ordinance. And so we're looking at a number of trees throughout the town. He's just got one of them. I've got three notices out right now. There's probably three or four more that could go out in the next 30 to 60 days that those trees need to be trimmed up or removed. He just happens to be one on the list as well.
I guess my question, Richard, is are you going to hire it, take it down, or are you going to try to do it yourself?
I will take it down myself.
I mean, but why can't you get it done now instead of
it's cold out.
Yeah, but back when you got the notice, it was pretty warm.
It never was a threat when no one owned both houses.
No, but so I'm saying it, you said it's too cold now to do it, but it was warm back there when you got the notice.
That's correct. I was slightly busy cleaning up the yard and probably finishing up the 400 there on the porch. I haven't been idle.
Well, there would be some pretty heavy liability if your tree fell on
sure
the
would.
House, you know.
Sure would, and I've had renters in there with five little kids and a renter that just left with three. And like I said, I'm pretty familiar with trees, and hackberry's pretty sturdy. You see the hollow there, but you don't see the back. You don't see how strong that back is. And those sides are very sturdy, and the roots are very well placed.
Katie,
it's in between two houses. Sorry.
I have a question, Katie. If we have made note of this tree and it's a violation, if we don't enforce it and it falls over, do we have any liability because we didn't?
Well, I guess the choice is whether you want to make a decision. If you choose now, let's say that you just don't give them any additional time, then our ordinance says that the city has to cut the tree down, and then this cost is assessed to the property. So the city would have to follow through with that.
What would be that cost, you know?
I honestly don't know.
My tree removed, it was about $350.
But the city didn't do it.
Well, I'm not a tree expert, so I can't. I just feel there's been sufficient time. I don't want to make a hardship on it.
Well, I say we move on and you know, there's plenty of notice been given and let's enforce the ordinance. That's what we have it for.
Well, the thing is, Richard was supposed to be here at the last meeting.
Right.
If he had come to that.
I didn't get a notice for the last meeting. I wrote for one and I waited for one, but I didn't get it until I told Chris I didn't get it and he came and brought me one personally. I would have been here on the first one.
Yeah. Well, you wrote a letter that you wanted to be on the council, if you wanted to address the council at the last meeting.
See, that's
and I never got it.
So.
I think we need to proceed.
I agree pretty much. Everybody? Okay. Thank you for coming to the meeting and Chris, proceed.
Yeah, very Merry Christmas to you too.
You're welcome. Next on the agenda is the consent agenda and appropriations 12B from the December 2nd.
Okay. On page 2 of 13, an acronym, supply. We have a number of coats, Mibble girls and whatnot. And I'd like to see who those are for. Okay. Just like, you know, have her put Able, Strike, whoever those are for.
Okay.
And then on page 5 of 13 on card services, there's a, like the hotels, who are they for? Or if they're, like if the guys go to the smoke school in Nebraska, put that down for what that's, or your school.
Mm-hmm.
Just who attended or what school it's for.
Okay.
And then, I had a question here on Tangle's gift certificate, but I think I know what that's for. And just the other hotel there, just what kind of a meeting it was for. On 6 of 13, what is the service orders on all of these for the Chamber of Commerce? I don't know. I'm not aware. I know we pay the membership dues.
Oh, but these are for chamber checks.
Okay.
For years of service.
Okay. And then on computer solutions, the tablet and software for the admin office, who is that for?
It's me.
Okay.
Yep.
And Chrome Service Center on page 9 of 13. I assume the gloves are for welding, or what are those gloves for? For $216.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, down
there. It's for the sewer distribution.
Yeah. Do you know what they're for?
Who are they for?
Yeah. Gloves at Kohler's.
Is they at
Kohl's? Kohl's, I'm sorry.
Oh, Kohl's. Yeah, they probably put welding and they're probably the thick insulated or bacteria also. If it's from the wastewater food. Okay. I'm not familiar with that one in particular.
Okay. On page 10 of 13, North Central Regional Planning Commission. It says Main Street Project Windows. We paid them $4,000.
Yeah, we get reimbursed for that.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Did we get reimbursed for that $23,000 we gave last mm-hmm. meeting?
Yep, I already got it.
And then the very last question I had was the law office of Scott Wright. I assume these must be court cases?
Those are attorney fees.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
That's all I had to ask.
And just for everybody's information, anytime you see those attorney fees,
city pays those up front, but then the defendants pay those back over time. They're allowed, they're usually given 60, 90 days to pay back their attorney fees, so.
That's all I have.
Okay. I don't have a question.
Go ahead.
I have one question. Under page 10 of 13 on Postmaster, the water standard mailing, could those not have been mailed with the utility billing, or do they have to be posted separately?
No, which one?
On Postmaster. Water standards mailing.
But they had to be mailed within 70 days, is that correct?
Yes, they had to be mailed by the 29th of this month, so it wasn't possible to wait until the next utility billing, and the previous billing had already gone out.
And you got that notice late?
Excuse me?
And you got that notice late?
I got the notice about the same time our billings came out.
Okay, thank you.
On that note, has the problem been corrected and fixed at the water plant?
As far as having scientific documentation, we won't know until the next quarter, but as far as the treatment aspect of it, we have done additional chemical treatment to alleviate that problem.
Well, I don't have a question. On all this stuff we bought from Ackerman's, I've made a note that any of this stuff that we can buy from a business inside the city of Beloit, I think we should keep it in the city and outside. That's my opinion.
Okay, if there's no further questions, I entertain a motion for approval. And moved by Councilman Audi that we approve the meeting minutes from December the 2nd, appropriations 12B. I have a second by Councilman Peterson. Any further discussion? No further discussion. Manny, please take a roll call vote.
Brown?
Yep.
Gingler?
Yes.
Miller?
Yes.
Abel?
Yes.
Audi?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Luttrell?
Yes.
Richard?
Yes.
Thank you. Motion carries. Next item on our agenda is a closed session for attorney-client privilege for 10 minutes to include the governing body to Attorney Cheney and Administrator Rod. Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Been moved by Councilor Brown, seconded by Councilman Abel. Any further discussion? No further discussion. Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same. Motion carries. We'll now go into a closed session for 10 minutes.
I'm not going to
I thought they were. I thought they were.